Each side accuses the other of breaking the ceasefire over the weekend, despite a call for negotiations that was backed by regional leaders at the end of last week. A spokesman for the rebel coalition told me that they were suspending once again their operations on the ground to allow a humanitarian access to the population and to start talks with the government. These talks, should they happen, should be taking place in Gabon under a regional mediation. But what is clear is that the rebels have the upper hand on the ground. They took over the town of Bambari on Sunday. This is the biggest town that they've taken so far, and it's definitely put more pressure on the administration. It's given the rebels a stronger position before sitting down for talks. Bambari is quite a strategic town because it's a sort of gate to the diamond mining sites and to the entire eastern part of the country. Now, Chad has stationed troops just under 200 kilometers north of the capital, Bangui. They're acting as a sort of buffer force should the rebels continue their advance. But let's remember that Chad has already helped President Bozize fight these rebellions several times over the past decade. So whether the rebel coalition would be able to march up to the capital, Bangui, is not entirely sure for now. What we are told, though, is that a fourth former rebel group has now joined the rebel coalition, and they say that it's up to President Bozize to stop what is going on by fully implementing previous peace agreements.